sit. I can't stop sitting with my mom. Gotta sit right here.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Amen.
Este es el día que hizo el Señor.
Praise Jesus.
Lejos sigamos y agradecemos en él. We thank each and every one of you for coming this morning and making it here. Agradecemos a todos y cada uno de ustedes por venir aquí esta mañana. We're going to start with two different songs, and you'll have the time after that to share your testimony. Vamos a comencemos con dos canciones, y luego, siguiendo las dos canciones, tendremos un tiempo para que compartas un testimonio. The songs are in English, but we have the lyrics in Spanish on a piece of paper. Los canciones están en inglés y tenemos las letras en un papel. So if everyone could just stand up, let's praise God.
Yes.
Pongamos a todos de pie y alabemos a Dios.
Intentional, never failing. I know that I'll.
I feel it. All right, now we're going to have our testimony. In the past week, have you seen or felt God working in your life? You're more than welcome to share.
En la última semana, ¿ha visto o sentido a Dios obrando en su vida? Le invitamos a compartirlo ahora.
Hey, I said that.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I just want to say, I just like to pray for the family that lost some good friends of mine, the Hesters and the Williams families. You know, they lost a family member, and they were good, close friends of mine, and I just want to pray for their family and also, you know, make sure they can get through this grief, and I will be with them till the end, until it's over. And I just want to pray for everyone else that's here too, and just thank the Lord, okay, for blessing us and waking us up this morning. Thank you.
Buenos días, hermanos. Lo que acaba de decir Nabo es que él quiere, acaba de perder un amigo, y él quiere que nosotros mantengamos a su amigo en oración. Era un amigo muy cercano a Nabo, y Nabo dice que él va a estar con ellos hasta el último. So, mantengamos a nuestro hermano Nabo y la familia, que él, el amigo que conoció en sus oraciones. Gracias.
Keep me, Lord, keep me. I have some hills to climb, keep me. Some tests and some trials, Lord. Keep me, just keep me, Lord.
Yo nomás le quiero dar gracias a Dios por este lindo día que Dios nos ha dado. El sol está brillando, abriendo nuestros ojos. Es una bendición poder estar aquí. I'm just very grateful to God that I'm here this morning. He gave me a new day, new mercies. You know, God is good, and I'm very blessed, you know, just to be able to do the things that I'm able to do, and I continue to serve him, of course, and I'm just very grateful to be able to be here. Anybody else? ¿Alguien quiere dar un testimonio?
Hey, Paul. You got to bring me up? And a pray for Patito, the woman. Amen.
Morning, sir. Porque Dios le abrió los ojos por esta mañana, por su hermana. ¿Y por quién más, Nacho?
For you.
Por mí y por todos los que están aquí. Gracias, Nacho.
Good morning, saints. It feels good to be in the house of the Lord again. I want to acknowledge my pastor, Herla, in his absence. He's a great leader, great provider. And not just a week ago, but about close to a month ago, I was able to receive my driver's license back again.
Amen.
After 15 years.
Wow. Amen.
So that was huge for me. And I'm still celebrating and trying to stay clean, follow the rules of the road, and drive safe. It's a lot of things, you know, going on around me and dealing with some changes, which I expected going into my early 40s. I'm 43 as of now. And I got 5 kids that I know of, 3 mothers. So I juggle them between 3 moms, and it can be very complicated at times, you know. And I stay with my mom and dad, it's just us 3. And we make the best out of it there, over at my parents' house. Been back home over there since I quit drinking. And it's been one of the most beautiful times of my life. And I come here on Sundays. Every Sunday I can get here, I come. And then there's like 1 or 2 more other churches that I attend. So I just want to thank everybody here for standing behind me and understanding my situation. my trials, and I hope that we can continue on our journey with the Lord. You know, having the favor of the Lord with us is the most important thing. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Date que Abraham. Abraham dice que le da gracias a Dios porque el que le agarró su licencia después de 15 años. Y también le da gracias a Dios porque también dejó de tomar y está viviendo con sus papás. Y dice que es una experiencia bonita la que está experimentando hoy. También da gracias por el pastor Scar y muchas cosas que están pasando en su vida que están bendiciendo a él. So I want to thank God for my life. And today was a really good lesson. I think it was a good lesson that we learned, because there's a lot of things that happen in the world that we don't understand why they happen or why God allowed this to happen. And we always sometimes ask ourselves why, right? But God said, Jesus says that unless we repent, we also will be perishing, you know? So our lesson today was based on the fact that we have a loving God that cares for us, and he wants the best for us. But he disciplines us, and we understand that after that we can feel God's presence saying, I do this because I love you. So that was a good lesson, and this was for me, and I hope it was for you too. But I wanna pray for God that my wife is gonna go through surgery this week, so we've been praying for her for everything to go well. And I know that God is gonna make a miracle. Entonces yo le doy gracias a Dios porque en nuestra clase de hoy de la Biblia aprendimos de que aunque hay muchas cosas que pasan en el mundo que no entendemos por qué pasan, muchas desgracias que pasan que quisiéramos comprender, pero la Biblia nos enseña que Dios es un Dios de amor, pero también es un Dios de justicia, y Él castiga a lo malo. Entonces las cosas pasan, y Jesús, cuando le hicieron esa pregunta, Él dijo que a menos que también nosotros nos arrepintiéramos, también vamos a perecer. Pero como hijos de Dios, tenemos un Padre que nos ama, que nos disciplina, y que al final de la disciplina nos da un abrazo y nos dice, yo lo hago esto porque te amo. Amén. Y por esa razón yo le doy gracias a Dios porque aprendimos esa lección. Y también porque le doy gracias a Dios porque mi esposa va a tener una cirugía el jueves, y estoy orando porque todo va a salir bien. Y yo le doy gracias a Dios por eso.
I know I want to say just I'm thankful to be here this morning. Thank that God woke me up this morning in my right mind. Gracias a Dios que ya woke up. Me despierte esa mañana. Y me, I just thank God that I'm able to be here because this Sunday is actually going to be Ashley's and my last Sunday here as interns preaching. We have like 2 more weeks and we're going to be leaving the Joliet Salvation Army, but we can come back for it as visitors.
We actually don't know yet.
To be determined.
So I'm just thankful to God that we were able to be here and actually able to do the message one more time for you guys and just to be able to make
worship.
It
yeah.
And worship with you.
Él dice que va a ser su última semana, ellos van a internos aquí en el cuerpo de Juliet, y hoy va a ser su último día que van a estar ellos participando. Tienen que ir a otro lugar, pero dice que de vez en cuando van a visitar. We appreciate you, Lord. Thank you for
and you know, we thank for everyone that shared this morning, has There is a time for everything. We just we pray for everyone that is going through it right now, and everyone that has surgeries coming up or any hard times throughout this week, loss in the families and friends. We're going to go into tithes and offerings. Y gracias a todos lo que han compartido. Vamos a pasar a la parte a diezmos y las ofrendas. While the next song plays, we welcome you to come down a few at a time and place your offering in the altar. Mientras suena la siguiente canción, los invitamos a que bajen unos cuantos a la vez al frente y coloquen su ofrenda en el altar.
Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you for all that you have done for us and bless us with. This morning, we would like to worship you by giving our tithes. Please take our offering, multiply it, and use it for your will. Amen.
Señor Dios, te damos gracias por todo lo que nos has bendecido. Esta mañana nos gustaría adorarte dando nuestros diezmos. Por favor, tome nuestra ofrenda, multiplícalo y utilízalo por tu voluntad. Amén.
Make some noise!
We have one more song just to prepare our hearts and our minds for the service and the sermon. Tenemos una canción más para prepararnos nuestros corazones y mentes para el sermón. If everyone wants to rise and sing, or you can sit in your chair, just praise the Lord how he wants you to.
Clap your hands, everybody, come on.
Faithful, faithful is our God. I'm reaching the harvest, the promise.
God is faithful, and I rejoice for who he is. Dios es fiel. We're going to read this morning from Matthew 6, 19 through 24. Vamos a leer de Mateo 6, versículos 19 a 24. It's in the back of the bulletin if you want to follow along, or you can read out of your Bibles as well.
Do not lay up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy, and where thieves break in and steal.
No acumulen para sí tesoros en la tierra, donde la polilla y el óxido destruyen, y donde los ladrones se meten a robar.
But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust destroys, and where thieves do not break in and steal.
Más bien, acumulen para sí tesoros en el cielo, donde ni la polilla ni el óxido carmonen y ni los ladrones se meten a robar.
For where your treasure is, there your heart will also be.
Porque donde esté tu tesoro, ahí estará también tu corazón.
The eye is the lamp of the body, so if your eye is healthy, your whole body will be full of light.
El ojo es la lámpara del cuerpo. Por tanto, si tu visión es clara, todo tu ser disfrutará de la luz.
But if your eye is bad, your whole body will be full of darkness. And if then the light in you is darkness, how great is the darkness?
Pero si tu visión está nublada, todo tu ser estará en oscuridad. Si la luz que hay en ti es oscuridad, que densa será esa oscuridad.
No one can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or he will be devoted to one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and money.
Nadie puede servir dos señores, pues menospreciaría a uno y amará al otro, o quiera mucho a uno y desprecia al otro. No se puede servir a la vez a Dios y a las riquezas.
So as we get into the sermon, the first question is, where is your treasure?
¿Dónde está tu tesoro?
So many things come to mind when I think of what Jesus is saying in these three verses that begin with our passage.
Tantas cosas me vienen a la mente cuando pienso en lo que Jesús está diciendo en estos tres versículos que comienzan nuestro pasaje.
Are you earthly minded or heavenly minded?
¿Eres de mentalidad terrenal o mentalidad celestial?
Are you investing in the future of eternity to come, or are you investing in the here and now?
¿Estás invirtiendo en la eternidad futura por venir, o estás invirtiendo en el aquí y ahora?
Now, obviously, all these questions are the same thing, but it's very important that we fully grasp this thought.
Ahora, obviamente, todos estos están preguntando lo mismo, pero es muy importante que captemos completamente este pensamiento.
Jesus uses the three examples below to show how the things we deem most important are just temporary.
Jesús usa los tres ejemplos a continuación para mostrar cómo las cosas que consideramos más importantes son solo temporales.
He uses moth, rust, and the thief.
Utiliza la polilla, el óxido, y la ladrón.
We can all think of examples of these things in our lives.
Todos podemos pensar en ejemplos de esas cosas en nuestras vidas.
For instance, someone drives a new car off the lot so proudly they love this vehicle.
Por ejemplo, alguien conduce un auto nuevo fuera del lote con tanto orgullo. Les encanta ese vehículo.
They have the windows rolled down, the music cranked, as they want the world to know, look, I just got this new car.
Tienen las ventanas bajadas y la música a todo volumen porque quieren que el mundo sepa que acaban de comprar este coche nuevo.
The next thing you know, a little humility comes, as they are sideswiped, and the new shiny car is destroyed and no longer of value.
La siguiente que sabes es que surge un poco de humildad cuando son golpeados y su nuevo aro brillante se destruye y ya no tiene valor.
Next is the moth. We all know when moth gets into our clothes, they eat holes right away.
La polilla. Todos sabemos que cuando las polillas se meten en nuestra ropa, la atraviesan.
The moth is a tiny looking butterfly looking animal that doesn't appear harmful at all.
La polilla es un pequeño animal parecido a una mariposa que no parece dañino en absoluto.
But it will destroy the most expensive, elaborated fabric you could ever own.
Pero destruirá a la tela más cara y elaborada que puedes tener.
Next is rust. As I grew up here in Illinois, as we all know, during the winter, they saw down the roads.
Oxido. Crecí aquí en Illinois. Todos sabemos que durante el invierno, las ciudades echan sal en la carretera.
You can have the nicest car in the world, but because of the snow, the salt rusts. Because of the snow, the salt rusts the car.
Podrías tener el coche más bonito del mundo, pero debido a la nieve, la sal oxida el coche.
Rust destroys, as moths do, the property and riches we work so hard for to obtain.
El óxido destruye, como lo hacen las polillas.
Lastly, is a thief. With money and riches comes great fear of someone taking them, so mankind does everything in his power to protect what he has.
El ladrón. Con el dinero y las riquezas vienen un gran temor de que alguien se los lleve. La humanidad hace todo lo que está a su alcance para proteger lo que tiene.
He puts walls around his house so no one can get in. He has security guards guarding them at all times and have hidden safe for his rare jewels.
Pone paredes alrededor de su casa para que nadie pueda entrar. Tiene guardias de seguridad que los custodian en todo momento y cajas fuertes ocultas para sus raras joyas.
So what does a thief do? He breaks in, takes everything that the wealthy man has worked hard for. A thief will do whatever he can to get whatever he wants.
¿Qué hace el ladrón? Él irrumpe y la toma todo lo que tiene el hombre rico y hará cualquier cosa para conseguirlo.
What do you deem as valuable? Because what you deem as valuable shows where your heart is.
¿Qué consideras valioso? Porque lo que consideras valioso te muestra dónde está tu corazón.
Maybe it's money, wealth, maybe it's power, and the desire to be recognized as a leader. Maybe it is looking spiritual on the outside, so people will think you have it all put together.
Tal vez sea el dinero y la riqueza. Tal vez sea el poder y deseo de ser reconocido como un líder. Tal vez se vea espiritual por fuera para que la gente piense que lo tienes todo bajo control.
Maybe it's popularity, acceptance through nice clothes, a home, a car, a Xbox, a PS5.
Tal vez sea la popularidad y la aceptan a través de ropa bonita, una casa o una Xbox.
Or maybe it's your family showing off that you raised great kids. Here, Jesus is calling us to change our minds from the temporary to the eternal, from the things that are passing by to the things that are permanent.
Tal vez sea tu familia y cómo has criado a niños geniales. Aquí Jesús nos está llamando a cambiar nuestra mente de lo temporal a lo eterno.
You will never see a hearse pulling a U-Haul trailer. If you did, you would be shocked. I know I would. Because we know the earthly treasures we store up cannot be taken with us even by the grave.
Nunca ves un coche fúnebre tirando de un remolque o U-Haul. Si lo hiciera, todos nos sorprenderíamos porque sabemos que los terceros terrenos con nosotros.
They are all temporary. All through the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus asked us to repent, to change our minds and our attitudes.
Son solo temporales. A lo largo del Sermón de la Montaña, Jesús nos pide que nos Ahora pensamos que cambiamos de opinión, de actitud.
Now it's easy to read verse 22 and think that Jesus has changed the subject in his sermon.
Ahora es fácil leer el versículo 22 y pensar que Jesús ha cambiado de tema en su sermón.
But if we look carefully at the context, we will notice he has not left the discussion of treasures in heaven, because in verse 24, he would continue to warn about serving God or serving money.
Pero si miramos detenidamente al contexto, notaremos que no ha dejado la discusión de los tesoros en el cielo, porque en versículo 24 siguiera advirtiendo sobre servir a Dios o servir al dinero.
So what is the point Jesus is making when he tells us to consider our eyes?
¿Cuál es el punto que Jesús quiere decir cuando nos dice que consideremos nuestros ojos?
First, Jesus begins with a statement. The eye is the lamp of the body. Jesus continues that when your eye is healthy, then your whole body will receive light.
Primero, Jesús comienza con una declaración. El ojo es la lámpara del cuerpo. Jesús continúa diciendo que cuando tu ojo está sano, entonces todo tu cuerpo recibirá la luz.
But if your eye is bad, then your whole body will be filled of darkness. It is truly a simple image.
Pero si tu ojo está mal, entonces tu cuerpo estará en tinieblas. Es realmente una imagen simple.
What are you looking at in your life? What is your eye set on? What are you focused on?
¿Qué estás mirando en la vida? ¿En qué está puesto tu ojo? ¿Cuál es tu enfoque?
What is the condition of the eye of our hearts? What is blocking our spiritual vision?
¿Cuál es la condición de los ojos de nuestro corazón? ¿Qué está bloqueando nuestra visión espiritual?
You see that Jesus is telling us that if we are continuing to look at money and possessions, then this problem cannot be fixed.
¿Ves que Jesús no está diciendo que si continuamos mirando en el dinero y las posesiones, entonces este problema no se puede solucionar?
What you are staring at is what is going on, what is affecting your heart.
Lo que estás mirando es lo que va a afectar tu corazón.
It is like thinking that we're going to stare at the Halloween candy when we get on Halloween, but we're not going to eat it.
Es como pensar que nos vamos a quedar mirando los dulces de Halloween, pero no comemos.
What we look at affects our heart. This is why lust corrupts the heart, wealth corrupts the heart, envy, jealousy corrupts the heart.
Lo que miramos afecta nuestros corazones. Por eso, la lujuria corrompe al corazón. La riqueza corrompe al corazón. Y la envidia corrompe al corazón.
Lastly, in the verse of 24, Jesus gives us the truth that we must accept and believe, which is no one can serve two masters.
Por eso, Jesús nos da esa verdad. Que debemos aceptar y creer. Nadie puede servir a dos señores.
We think we can, but we cannot. It's impossible to divide our heart to serve a master properly.
Creemos que podemos, pero no podemos. Es imposible que un corazón divado sirva adecuadamente a un amo.
Either I'm putting my hope in and seek after the treasures of this earth for my joy and satisfaction, or I'm putting my hope in and seeking after God for my glory and satisfaction.
O pongo mi esperanza y busco los deseos de esta tierra para mi gozo y satisfacción. O pongo mi esperanza y busco a Dios para mi gozo.
We cannot be a full and faithful servant to both.
No podemos ser esclavos plenos y fieles de ambos.
Either we're going to serve God over self, or we're going to serve self over God.
O estamos sirviendo a Dios sobre nosotros mismos, o a nosotros mismos sobre Dios.
There is not another option. The things of this world are rivals to the love of God. Money is the root of all evil. We look to money to bring us security, peace, happiness, and hope rather than God.
No hay otra opción. Las cosas de este mundo son rivales del amor de Dios. El dinero es la raíz de todo mal. Buscamos en el dinero para que nos brinde seguridad, paz, felicidad, y esperanza en lugar de Dios.
We cannot serve God and also serve something else or someone else. Only one person can be on the throne of our hearts. It is either God on the throne of our heart or it is ourselves on the throne.
No podemos servir a Dios y también servir a la otra cosa o a alguien más. Solo una persona puede estar en el trono de nosotros, de nuestros corazones. Es Dios o soy yo mismo quien está en el trono.
They cannot coexist. This is why Jesus said that we had to deny ourselves, take up our cross and follow him. I cannot rule my life and think that God is ruling it also.
No pueden coexistir. Por eso Jesús dijo que teníamos que negarnos a nosotros mismos y tomar nuestras cruces y seguirlo. No puedo gobernar mi vida y pensar que estoy dejando que Dios gobierne mi vida.
I cannot store up the treasures on this earth myself and think that I have stored up treasures on heaven for myself also. We must also choose this day who will we serve.
No puedo acumular los tesoros de la tierra para mí y pensar que también he acumulado los tesoros del cielo para mí. Debemos elegir este día a quién serviremos.
Jesus calls for true disciples to truly be honest with themselves and consider what are they storing up.
Jesús llama a los verdaderos discípulos a ser verdaderamente honestos consigo mismos y considerar dónde han guardado sus tesoros.
One way we know this is by looking at our hearts. Where our treasure is, there your heart will be also.
Una forma en que podemos saber es mirando en nuestros corazones. Donde esté nuestro tesoro, ahí estará también vuestro corazón.
So what do you look at? What do you desire? What do you trust in? What do you hope in?
Entonces, ¿qué miras? ¿Qué deseas? ¿En qué confías? ¿Qué esperas?
What is your goal in life? What are you striving for?
¿Cuál es su objetivo en la vida? ¿Por qué te esfuerzas?
Jesus presents a choice between two ways of life.
Jesús presenta una elección entre dos formas de vida.
There are two treasures. Will you store your treasures here, on earth, or in heaven?
Hay dos tesoros. ¿Almacenas tesoros en la tierra o en el cielo?
There are two eyes. Will your eyes be light or will it be darkness?
Hay dos ojos. ¿Nuestros ojos serán claros o serán oscuros?
There are two masters. Will it be God or will it be yourself and your possessions?
Hay dos maestros. ¿Será Dios o serán las posesiones? We have one more song to conclude the sermon. It's a time of reflection. If you want to, you can come pray at the altar. Tenemos una canción más para la reflexión. Y quieres, puede orar en su siente o en el altar.
Ask the person next to you, would you still say yes?
Say yes. Yeah.
My
soul says yes, Jesus. My soul says yes.
Just say yes,
my
Lord.
My soul says yes.
Because he's there.
My soul says yes. Prayer. He's saying there is more that I require.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for your goodness, your kindness, and your mercy. Lord, we're saying yes to
there
you, Lord God. We are saying yes to when even things are tough and we don't see an end. We're saying yes to when we're just so distraught, Lord God, in our hearts and our minds. But you are
here.
You have never been in our hearts, Lord God. So why should we give you glory? Lord, bless us through this week.
He said, don't be afraid of men in the faces. Don't be afraid, don't be afraid, don't be afraid.
Hey, hey. We have a purpose.
He said, I'm calling you out of your dry places. I'm calling you out of your dry places. Say it. Come on up a little higher. Come on up a little higher. Come on up a little higher. 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 I'm calling you. I predestined you before the world.